Will guests please rise for the rendering of military honors and remain standing?
Thank you. of that command. The change of command is nearly unique in the world today. It is a transfer of total responsibility, authority, and accountability from one individual to another. Yes, please be seated.
Thank you. Colonial Navy of Massachusetts.
Special order dated 10 March 1990. Subject, relief of command. 2, Commodore Armand F. Laney, CNF. Pursuant to the provisions of Chapter 835 of the Acts of 1967 and the provisions of Chapter 180 and Section 7, Chapter 3 of the General Laws of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, you are hereby relieved of your duties and responsibilities as Commanding Officer of the Colonial Navy of Massachusetts, effective this date. You are hereby transferred to line duty with the fleet to serve as a member of the flag of staff officers, and you shall carry out or cause to be carried out all duties and responsibilities as may be designated by the Commodore. Signed and sealed this 10th day of March, 1990 at Fall River, Massachusetts, William J. Webb, Captain, CNM, Clerk.
Ladies and gentlemen, Captain William Brayton, Colonial Navy of Massachusetts.
Thank you. Wheel. I go?
I'd like to just introduce several of the special guests that are with us this evening, and if they would just rise briefly and to be recognized. We have with us this evening Mr. Larry Gay, Chairman of the Board of Selectmen of Town of Somerset. Mrs. Lawton Brayton, Commodore Brayton's mother. The Commodore's sister, Mrs. Cornelia Roach, and her son Gregory here tonight. And Evelyn Wardell and her husband Brad, Bill's brother-in-law, I guess it must be Barbara's brother.
Sister.
Very good. Sister. And we have longtime friends of the Colonial Navy, our travel planners, Jerry and Lil Silver. I'd like everyone to rise for a moment while we have Captain Noble give the invocation, please.
Heads of prayer. Oh Lord God, our Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for this wonderful opportunity to celebrate this evening. We thank Thee for the gift of Bill Brayton, who's going to serve as our Commodore, and the joy that it will bring to him as he leads us. A wonderful unit that God has blessed with so many musicians and men who are dedicated to their nation. Lord, we thank Thee for this entire evening. We thank Thee for Sonny Laney's tenure as the Commodore and his family. And we pray that Thou will bless this food, O Lord. Strengthen us as we carry on Thy glorious work. In Thy holy name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thanks, Mom.
Thanks. Go up, take our seats so we can get this part of the speaking program over with, and you can enjoy the rest of the evening. Oh, Carol, you don't have to run. At this time, I'd like to ask Mr. Larry Gay, the chairman of the Board of Selectmen for the Town of Somerset, if he'd like to say a few words, please. Just a few words, Larry.
20 seconds.
You only had a minute and a half of the motor guy.
Thank you, Norman. The Commodore Brayton, past Commodore Laney, officers and crew of the Colonial Navy, guests and family, I want to welcome all of you here tonight. And on behalf of the citizens of the Town of Somerset, we're very proud to be represented this year. And during his tour of duty to the new Commodore Bill Brayton. He's been a very loyal and dedicated member of the Colonial Navy for many, many years. And we have witnessed the Colonial Navy in Somerset on several occasions marching in our parades. And they always present a very good impression. And we hope that that will continue, and we hope it will continue, because with Bill Brayton as the new Commodore, I'm sure that he'll lead you proudly for the next couple of years. So Bill, good luck and congratulations.
Could I ask Commodore Laney to step forward, please? I'm going to read this, and it's going to take a few minutes, but I'm going to read it anyhow. It's the City of Fall River official citation. Be it hereby known to all, the City of Fall River, Massachusetts expresses its sincerest gratitude to Commodore Armand F. Laney, Colonial Navy of Massachusetts, in recognition of his contribution to the community through his participation in the Colonial Navy. For this, the entire citizenry says thank you and best wishes. we open this 10th day of March 1990 by Carlton Hemphill's mayor. Commonwealth of Massachusetts State Senate, official citation. Be it known that the Massachusetts Senate hereby extends its congratulations to Captain Ahmed F. Laney in recognition of your services as Commodore of the Colonial Navy of Massachusetts. And be it further known that the Massachusetts Senate extends best wishes for continued success. That this citation be duly signed by the President of the Senate and attested to and a copy thereof transmitted by the Clerk of the Senate. Signed by William F. Bulger, President of the Senate, attested by Edward B. O'Neill, Clerk of the Senate, and it was offered by State Senator Thomas F. Norton, dated March 10, 1990.
Yeah, sure, Leo.
Believe me, I am truly humbled. I thought I was going to come out here and do a little fun and games and say, hey guys, you know, I bet you think I wasn't going to say nothing, but I am. With these awards, I guess I'm second fiddle. I would like to impose your indulgence, folks, for the people who didn't go to Portugal. We did a little hustle and scuttle here to get some ribbons together to make sure that we made them for tonight, and we got them at 1 o'clock this afternoon. They are not in alphabetical order. They are strictly the way they come out of the bag. Buck Hadley, thank you for Portugal.
Thank you.
Chuck Harris.
Thank you for
Myself,
are you thinking of the beach?
Hey.
Yeah. What went on the beach?
No, what was not on the beach? We're standing up. Lou Boyle? Right, Frank?
Yeah, what is it?
You went to the other beach. We didn't.
Paul told him to keep my mouth shut.
Okay. Billy Webb? Thank you, Chick. John Cummings?
Well, there's the guy who's on the beach.
There's the guy who's on the beach.
John was sunburned every day.
Our honorary representative, Jerry Sylvia. I want to see this in every coach every time I see you. No. You got it. Brad Hadley. Brad's not here. Next.
Hey, Brad.
Just happy.
Brad's not here.
Thank you, Brad. Commodore Bill Brink. Bill Woodard, the other Taunton Clydesdale.
Such a class.
I love you. I'm glad I got someone to take a half a slot. Frank Noble, he's a jockey.
Just gonna speak.
I said jockey, but Clydesdale, relax. I told you I was going to be serious, guys. Randy Martell. This is for making sure the trailer got fixed last year. Thank you, Randy. Pleasure. Bingo. Bing McGrath. Pleasure, man. Frank Culinary. Yeah. you. Thank you, Frank. Mighty Mike Bill Murray. The only guy that has the historical archives of the medical enterprise of Fall River tied up for the next 20 years. Thank you, Bill. Nice having you with us. If I forget anybody, the rest of the medals are home, okay? I enjoyed leading you guys. I enjoyed your support. You supported me excellent. And if you support Mr. Brayton half or three quarters as much as you supported me, we'll have a hell of a couple of years. Thank you very much.
And maybe perhaps a word of warning to the new Commodore. It's certainly not my intent to embarrass anyone here this evening, but then again, we know the road to hell is always paved with good intentions. For the recent past Commodore, when I was thinking about Sonny and what I could say about him, what I came up with was a poem that I remembered from quite a while ago, and I looked it up and there's a cute little ditty by Ogden Nash, and it goes something like this. Hark to the whimper of the seagull. He weeps because he's not an eagle. Suppose you were, you silly seagull. Could you explain it to your she-gull? Sonny, you're unique. Just as that seagull, you are unique, and you need to be unique. And like me, you sort of emulate the seagull. And any salt here that happens to know what they call seagulls in the Navy, what I had in mind was you like to eat a lot, and you probably squawk occasionally. But it's your uniqueness that made me, and I'm sure every man Jack here, proud to follow you. Thank you. Ruthie, I'm thrilled that the new Commodore is dedicating his tenure of command to Captain Ralph Malik. My only disappointment is that Ralph never got to wear that gauntlet himself. But on the other hand, Ralph was a real inspiration to me while I served as Commodore, and his leadership came through at that time. So, as we're marching along, Ralph, in spirit, will always be with the Colonial Navy of Massachusetts. The love and joy that's in our hearts and minds will always keep Captain Ahab right beside us. Anyone who knew Ralph knows that he was, in fact, what the Colonial Navy is all about. And that is tradition, patriotism, love of country, certainly love of family, and the brotherhood of shipmates. Commodore! You assume command. Assumed.
When?
Command. I've already spoken to your wife about this. I'm sure it's one of the greatest thrills of your life, Bill, and it is a wonderful experience. But I saw one of those bumper stickers the other day. Perhaps you've all seen it, too. It says something like, excrement happens. Something like that. It caused me to recall some happenings to past Commodores, and I thought I'd pass them along, and you might take a lesson from them. Do you remember Commodore Silva in Dearborn? as we're marching down Main Street proudly without our Commodore in front of us, and noticing him as he waved to us from the train. Buck, Hadley, what's that called when you don't make where you're supposed to be? Missing?
Missing movement.
Don't miss movement. Commodore Peteransky. We may remember Limerick, when Commodore Peteransky lost his voice. And then Vice Commodore Noble had to be the ventriloquist for the day, as he lip-synced my orders. Wonderful, Norm, wonderful. He almost blew the whole trip with the Sylvians, you know. They told him how brave we were going to be, and he can't talk. Commodore Williamson, down in Newport, trying to give an order and throwing his sword. How the hell could that ever happen to anyone? No one remembers Conkin, huh?
Yeah, we do.
Commodore Laney. Something that you should know about, Bill, you were there. Marching alone, Commodore Laney, marching out there in front of everyone, alone, because no one would follow him. Yours is coming, Bill. So enjoy tonight. You never know when fate or the CNN will take over. And Bill, a gentle reminder of what responsibility really means, as heard from the lament of this poor, lonely seaman. It's a little poem entitled, My Job. It goes something like this. It's not my place to run the ship, the horn I cannot blow. It's not my place to say how far the ship's allowed to go. It's not my place to chart the course nor even toll the bell. But let the damn thing start to sink and see who catches hell. Now, I happen to know that Bill loves it when we talk salty. So, Bill, in all sincerity, may your command have smooth sailing with fair winds and a following sea.
I think that this is probably an excellent time to finish the speaking program by having the Commodore address the room. Bill?
Well, this, I just have to say, wow, this is great. It's been a great night, and if everyone, I wish that everyone could experience seeing you guys come from a doorway like that at the drill hall. It's a sight to behold. It really is. I'm awed by it all still, but I will finish by saying that one of my jobs is to keep all you guys in line and tell you when everything is coming up. So I will suggest that there is a meeting next Tuesday night, and we have a game next Saturday morning in Newport. So it's been great, and Frank, thank you for your advice.
Trust me.
I'm not sure.
Bill, don't.
Common. It's been great.
Pleasure.
Back to
Painting up all right. Go finish up tomorrow.